Class, today we're going to be learning how to solve quadratics using a method called completing the square. And we're going to be solving the quadratic that you see here. Quadratics are always in the form of some number times x squared plus some other number times x plus another number that would be your constant on the end. And the coefficient of x squared we always have represented by an a, and the coefficient in front of the x term is always represented by a b, and the constant on the end is always a c, like you see here. And so when we refer to a, b, or c, we'll be referring to those particular numbers during this process. And we're going to actually start with our particular equation equaling 0 on one side. That is not always the case in your problem, but you can still go through the same steps exactly the way that we do that. So the first thing that we're going to do is, during this process, you want all of your variables on one side and your number or your constant on the other side. So the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to subtract our c, which in this case is 3, from both sides. That's going to make this cancel, and we will be left with 2x squared plus 5x equals negative 3. Now, the second step is very important for this particular process also. In this process, we want to make sure that this number in front of x squared is 1. So we want all our letters on one side, and we want a 1 here. So if you don't have a 1 in this a slot right here in front of x squared, you'll want to divide everything in the whole equation by that value. So we're going to go ahead and divide everything by 2, because that's our a in this particular problem. And sometimes you do end up with some fractions when you're doing that, and that's fine. You'll just deal with them as fractions using your fraction rules. Once we've divided by 2 in this particular problem, we will end up with x squared plus 5 halves x equals negative 3 halves. Now is where we do something that is kind of strategic in this process. It actually gives the process its name. The name of this process is called completing the square. So what we're going to do is turn this side of the equation into a nice perfect square. And we're going to strategically do that by taking a look at this value right here and what we would know about a perfect square pattern. And for a perfect square pattern, you would have a perfect square here, which we do. We have x squared. You would also have a perfect square added onto the end. So we're going to need to add something onto the end. So I'm going to put plus and then a blank for a little space for where we will add that strategic thing we're going to find for the end. But if I add something to that side of the equation, I am also going to have to add that same thing to the other side of the equation. Now, the trick is figuring out what that is. In a perfect square pattern, we have a perfect square here. We also have one here. And we want this to factor into the perfect square, which means both factors have to be identical. So whatever we put here is going to have to make it so when you add the square root of it to itself, you get the number that's here. So we're going to strategically make that happen, and every time you will do the same thing in order to make that happen. What you do is you take this number, which is the coefficient of your x at this time, in this case it's 5 halves, and you multiply it by 1 half. The reason why you multiply it by 1 half is because when you FOIL out a perfect square, you end up with two terms that are identical. So to figure out what those two terms are, you cut this number in half to get back to those two terms. And so we're going to multiply it by half to see what that is, but then we have to square it to figure out what number should go in these blanks in order to make this a perfect square. And whatever we put here, we're also going to put here. So let's calculate this out. Nothing cross cancels, so we multiply straight across and we get 5 4s, and then we have to square it. And when we square it, we get 25 over 16. So that's what I am going to add in right here. And if I add it there, I have to add it to the other side. Now, we have created a nice perfect square here. So what our goal is going to be is to factor that now. And when you factor something where you have a 1 out here in front of your x squared, you can do a shortcut where you look for two things that will multiply to get this number here and add up to this number here. Now, since you have fractions, that's a little tricky, except for we created a perfect square on purpose. So whatever you squared over here, which in this case is the 5 4s, when you add it to itself, you should get the number in the middle. And watch, 5 4s plus 5 4s is 10 4s, which reduces to 5/2. And if you take 5 4s times 5 4s, you get the 25/16 on the end. That means that this would factor into an x plus 5 4s times an x plus 5 4s, which we can just write as x plus 5 4s squared. So that's why this is working the way it's supposed to. Let's go ahead and just write it as x plus 5 4s squared. So I'm gonna take away the work that we just did and write it in its factored form, which is x plus 5 4s squared. Now, once you have factored the perfect square that you completed on this side over here, you want to go ahead and simplify the other side. And on the other side, we need common denominators, which will in this case be 16. So I need to multiply both the top and the bottom of this fraction here by 8. And that's going to give me a negative 24 over my 16. So when I add negative 24 with positive 25, I get 1 over 16. Now that we have created a perfect square over here on our left-hand side, we can go ahead and use the square root property to solve this. So we will square root both sides. And when you square root both sides, remember that on this right-hand side, you need to insert your plus or minus. The square and the square root cancel each other out, which leaves you with an x plus 5 4s. And on the other side, you square root the number that you have there. Now, sometimes it's not a perfect square. In this case, we did get lucky and it was a perfect square. But if it's not, just simplify the square root and then leave your plus or minus in front of it. In this case, we can actually go ahead and square root 1 and get 1, and square root 16 and get 4. And we will go ahead and leave our plus or minus symbol in front. Now to solve this, we just need to move our 5 4s. So when we do that, we will subtract 5 4s from both sides, and on this side I like to insert it in front of my plus or minus because it makes the next step easier. And then you just simplify as if possible. So we have x equals, and then over here, notice since we had a nice neat number here of 1/4, we can actually go ahead and finish this into two nice answers, one doing the plus and one doing the minus. If not, we would just go down to our simplified form of our radical in this step. But since we do have a nice neat number, let's separate it and calculate those two numbers. We have a negative 5 fourths plus 1 fourth, which ends up being negative 4 over 4, or negative 1. So we have negative 1, or the other answer would be with a negative 5 fourths minus 1 fourth. And that becomes a negative 6 fourths, which you can reduce into negative 3 halves. And that's the process. Every problem, no matter what it looks like, you'll do the same steps. So let's review the steps that we did here. The first thing we did was we moved whatever our C value was to the opposite side of where our variables were, which is over here. So we left our variables on this side and moved, in this case, our 3 over to get a negative 3 on this side. The second step is to, if your A is not 1, divide everything by it. And that's what we did here with dividing by our 2. And that left us with this here and negative 3 halves on this side. So then we had to strategically find our 25 sixteenths in order to create a perfect square on this left side. And we did that by taking this 5 halves times 1 half and squaring it. And every time you'll take whatever's in front of your x, multiply it by 1 half, and square it. That's where we got our 25 sixteenths, which had to be added to both sides of our equation. That made it so this was a perfect square, which we could factor into x plus 5 fourths squared, which allowed us to do the square root property, on which made it so we square rooted both sides and inserted a plus or minus on the side with our number. And then we just solved like normal and got our solution.